Hello everyone and welcome back to another tutorial video. Today, I'm going to show you how to change your iPhone ringtone or even text tones to any song that you want quickly and for free, and you don't need any paid apps or anything like that. So I do want to say a few things. Number one, make sure that you have installed the most up-to-date iOS software. So for me, this is iOS version 15. So depending on when you're watching this, make sure you have the up-to-date software. And then you'll need Safari, which is the normal mobile browser for iOS. And then GarageBand. So if you don't have GarageBand installed, it's a free app. You can get off the App Store. Just go there and search for GarageBand. All right. And the first thing that you want to do is open up a new browser tab in Safari. And you need to go and find royalty-free or copyright-free music. Again, I'm not going to encourage that you download and utilize songs that you don't have the rights to. Also, just a quick note, you can use songs that are automatically downloaded to your phone via Apple Music. So if you already have Apple Music and you have those songs on your device, then you can use those very easily. And this method will work for those. And it's even quicker to do that as well. All right, so the first thing that I've done here is I've tracked down some audio files here. I subscribe to a service called Envato Elements, so this is how I'm going to get my royalty-free music. This is just to show you how to do this. So what you need to do now is find the audio track that you want to use. So as you can see here, I found this track, which is titled Clocks, and then what I want to do is download that to my device. Now, the easiest way to do this is go open up a new tab and Google copyright-free music, or the song track title that you're trying to use, and then the letters MP3, and then select the first couple that come up, and you should be able to download that directly on your device, okay? So here we are. I'm going to go ahead and download this file here. The name of the song is Clocks, so I'm going to go ahead and go to download, and then I'm going to go ahead and access that by going to add download, and then it says, do you want to download? And then I do want to download that file. Now, for me, this is being downloaded as a .zip file. What we want is a .mp3. So I showed you this to show you a little bit of a workaround. So now in the upper left-hand corner, you're going to see a down arrow. If we tap on that down arrow there, it'll take us to our downloads. So let's go ahead and go to our downloads. And as you can see here, this is what we just downloaded. If you tap on the magnifying glass, it will take you to your downloaded folders, okay? So we want to tap on that zip file there, and then it will unzip it here, and then we just tap on the folder, and here we go. We will have our MP3 and WAV files. But the one that we want is MP3 files. That's something you need to understand and remember. So now that we have these files and they've downloaded to our device, we want to hop over to GarageBand, okay? So make sure you've downloaded GarageBand and you have your MP3 file downloaded. All right, here we are in GarageBand, and we want to create a new project. So in the upper right hand corner, we are going to see a blue addition symbol. If we just tap on that blue addition symbol here, we want to select the audio recorder, which should be the first one that comes up. But if it doesn't, you can just slide left or right until you get to your audio recorder. Then we just select the microphone there that says clean. And then we'll see in the upper left hand corner, we'll see a button that looks like a brick there. If we tap on that, that will then take us to our track editor. Now we want to import the song that we just added from the downloads there into our track here. The first thing that we want to do is go ahead and set the time to 30 seconds, which is the max time duration that you can use for a ringtone. So we have the little white addition or plus symbol in the upper right-hand corner of our timeline. If we just tap on that, it will bring a drop-down menu that says Song Selections. Go ahead and tap on the section A there that says 8 bars. And we want to go ahead and change the, right here where it says manual, we want to go ahead and increase that all the way up to 30. You can actually, tap it or just go ahead and hold it down to get that to go all the way up to 30. This will take us to the 30-second max that we can have for our section or song length. And that, as you see, will increase that all the way to 30. Now we need to get our song that we just downloaded on the device into the timeline. In order to do that, you'll see something here that looks like a little swirly cue or a loop-to-loop on a roller coaster. It's in the upper right-hand corner there. If we tap on that guy there, we will then see a couple of options. We will see Apple Loops, which are kind of pre-made loops or audio files within GarageBand. The one that we want to go to is Files, and then we can go to Search Files, and I'll show you how to do that quickly. But I want to show you really briefly, if we go to the Music tab here, We can then begin to search our Apple Music library. As you see here, I can use any of these that I have on my Apple Music library within my device. Again, not the ones that are on your computer, but the ones that are on your actual device. And then what you would do is you would just take those audio files and drag those onto the timeline, like what I'm doing here. And I did a podcast file just because I don't want to get a strike on the video here. All right, navigate back over to your audio manager here and go to files, which is the middle option there. And then we want to go to browse items from the files app. And then we go to browse here and then go to downloads, which is where that file should be. Go to the folder if you had to unzip the file. If not, you should see your MP3 file there for you. Select that MP3 file, rename it if you want to. So I'm going to go ahead and select that file. And then once I've done that, you should see it here in the drop-down menu. I'm just going to tap and hold and begin to drag that over to my timeline on GarageBand. And this is where the fun part of trimming the file comes into play. You can just tap here on the audio track and you'll see something here that says trim. And you'll just tap on the trim option there to begin kind of trimming your track. But as you can see here, I can go and increase or decrease where it starts at. And then I can kind of end it at 29 seconds, or it can even be shorter than 30 seconds if you want. So once you've trimmed up the track exactly like you want it, you want to go ahead and export this onto your device. That way we can save it as a ringtone or a .ringtone file on your device. And now we want to tap on the downward facing arrow in the upper left-hand corner of our screen, and then just tap on the My Songs option there to kind of go ahead and save it. That's going to be kind of the default name for everything you do in GarageBand. And then once it has saved and you have it here as my song, whatever it may be, now all we have to do is just tap and hold on the song or project that we just created. And then we want to go to where you see the share option here. So we tap on the share option and we'll have a few different options. But the one that we want to select obviously is ringtone. So go ahead and tap on the ringtone option there. And then we'll get a little thing here that says your ringtone length needs to be adjusted. So if it is longer than 30 seconds, you will get this notification. It will automatically adjust it. I recommend you go back in if you get this, but go ahead and tap on continue if you do and you want to move on. And then we'll just give our ringtone a name. And then once you name it, go ahead and go to export in the upper right-hand corner there. It'll export as a ringtone. It may take a few seconds here. Then you'll see something that says ringtone export successful. Now what I want you to do is just tap on OK and let's navigate to our phone settings. All right, here we are on our phone settings. I want you to scroll down to where you see something that says sounds and haptics. If we tap on sounds and haptics there, we will then see the ringtone option. So tap on the ringtone option. And now, as you can see, the fun ringtone that we just created in GarageBand and just downloaded from our Safari web browser can be selected. And as you can see, that will now be selected as our ringtone. And as you can see, we can create this with any song that we can download as an MP3 file from the internet. Hopefully this was helpful. If you have any questions about how to do this, please put that in the comment section down below. I'll have it timestamped so you can kind of jump and hop around to where you need to go to or where you're stuck in the process. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more great tutorials just like this. And I will see you guys in the next video.